And in this video, today we are going to discuss about how to take screenshots on failure in Cucumber BDD framework. So the steps we are going to follow are, first we will add the dependency in our pom.xml file. The dependency is extent report Cucumber 6 adapter. Then we will create a class called hook, and inside hook we will create a method to take screenshots on failure, and we'll be using after hook. So let's start. Okay, so this is my feature file where the scenario is login Facebook and create account. Actually, we won't be logging into Facebook. We'll be just open Safari browser, navigate to the application URL. We will navigate to Facebook, and there in the first name field, we'll be entering test user one. So intentionally, we will fail this step, and we'll see after execution this scenario, a screenshot will be taken and added in our extent report. So this is the hook class we have created here. We have written one method called take screenshot on failure, which will be responsible to take a screenshot once our test case is failed. And we have used after hook here. And we have given order as 1. Since we have used another method here, so order 1, we have given order 1. So 1 means this test, this method will be executed first, and then this method will be executed first. So first it will take screenshot if our test case is failed, and then later it will close the browser instance. So in this method, take screenshot method, we have passed the scenario argument here. Scenario is a class, and we have given a variable name, object name called scenario. So we inside if block, scenario class has one method called isFailed. So we have given one condition, since we want to take a screenshot only if our test case is failed. So we have given one condition, scenario isFailed is a method which will return a boolean value here. So in case our test case is failed, it will return as false, and the control will come inside this if block, and this test case will execute, and after that it will take a screenshot and embed in our extent report. So here in this method, we are using this text screenshot interface. We are creating the reference to this interface, and this object has one method take screenshot. This interface has one method called get screenshot as. So we are using that get screenshot as method to take a screenshot. It will capture the screenshot. If you see this description, method description, capture the screenshot and store it in a specified location. So it will take the screenshot and it will store it on a specified location. So we have just given the reference as SRC here. So here the output type, we can take different output types. So output type, we have the file output type we have taken as byte. Here we can use some other output type as well. We can use base64 files in class, but we are using byte. So, and the return type is arif byte. So we are giving this return type and taking it, storing it in a reference SRC. Now, there is another method in scenario. This is the main method which is responsible, you know, to attach that screenshot which we have taken into extent report. So scenario class, earlier before this adapter 6, I guess 4 and 5, they have method called embed. So but now that embed method is deprecated, and they have come up with a new method called attach. So we'll be using this attach method. So attach, we have given the source here from where we have already specified. This is the source here. It has taken the screenshot. We have given the source here. Now what is this? Media type. So media type, if you see here, media type can be image hyphen png. So we have given this image hyphen png here, and this is just a string we have given, so string name, so we have given name as screensort. Now this method will be executed first and then this method, so this method will close this browser instance. So let's execute our scenario and we'll see if it takes screenshots or not. But before that, let us check whether, yes, we have intentionally disturbed this XPath here. It has at name equal to first attribute was at name equals to first name. We have added this 1, 2, 3 so that this test case will fail. So let's execute this test case and we'll see whether it is taking screenshots or not. So here is, this is our runner class. So right click run as JUnit. It will open Safari browser. Taking some time, yeah, it opened browser instance, then Facebook, and then it couldn't enter the text in the first name field. So the reason is no such, is throw no such element exception because we have given a wrong XPath here. So now let's go to our project, refresh this and go to target directory, and this target directory we have already define in, we have already set in extent dot properties. Here it is, these are different reporter here. We are we have extent HTML reporter of extent report, logo reporter, and spark report reporter. I'm using all these three. I have given specified the properties here, and the directory screenshot dot directory is target directory where it will take the screenshot here, target here, and this is we have to use this property as well, screenshot.rel.path.forward/. So this is also required. So now after execution we can see it has taken one screenshot here, embedded one it has taken. Let us close this and we'll see the reports. We'll see only one report here. We can go to Spark, open this report. So this is the scenario, login Facebook. Login Facebook and create account, click here. So the first step given, open open Safari browser, it is passed, navigate to application URL, passed, user enters first name as test user 1, this is failed, it throw no such element exception, and there finally this is step hook class, from hook class this is the step, the method take a screenshot on failure, it is executed and it takes a screenshot. So we can check another reporter as well. Let's see HTML report. Go to extent report, extent HTML. So there as well. This step is passed, second step is passed, third step is failed. Here it is throwing no such element exception. And then finally it has taken a screenshot. It's now showing here. We have to click here and it will show the screenshot here. So now we have taken screenshot when our test case is failed. Every time whenever our test case is failed, it will take the screenshot, paste it in the directory and embed in our extent report. Now one important thing I would like to tell you guys is we have used this dependency, we have added this dependency in our pom.xml file, extent report number 6 adapter. So just go to this dependency hierarchy and search for extent. Yeah, there it is. So extent, this is the dependency we added, and inside this dependency we got extent report as well. So extent report version is 4.1.6. so we haven't added extent report in our pom.xml file separately, the dependency for extent report. It is embedded in this Cucumber 6 hyphen adapter dependency. So this is called transitive dependency. So here we no need to add this extend report separately. If we add it, we will get some sort of exception. So to avoid exception, we no need to add any dependency here. So that's it guys for today. I hope you like the video. If you find the video helpful, then please like it and subscribe to my channel as well. Thank you.